Thank you. Good morning, everyone. We have Dr. Somnath here, our speaker. Now, Meenakshi will offer her special pranams in the form of a Swati Tirunal, right? Kirtana to Dr. Somnath, who also happens to be a great music lover. He also has learned music. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Inspired Indian Foundation, I welcome all of you to this 5th Gurukula Memorial Lecture and Inspired Indian Foundation Awards for the Inspiring Indians and Unsung Heroes. Due to COVID protocols, we have kept the event in the sense we haven't invited too many people this time. So all of you are here, truly special guests to us. I also welcome our chief mentor, Dr. Kota Harinarayana, Mrs. Kota Harinarayana, and our speaker, Dr. Somnath. You know, a lot of people, this event is live across many channels. We are live streaming it. A lot of people are watching, and including many of our followers abroad. Very, very inspiring speech it will be, Dr. Somnath's. And of course, all other dignitaries, Vimal Kumar, the Olympian, and his wife, Dr. Tessie Thomas. That's a surprise package we have today for all of you. The Agniputri, the missile lady of India, and Also, special welcome to all the award winners. So now we have the lighting of the lamp. I request Dr. Kota Harinarayana, Dr. Somnath, Tessie Thomas ma'am, Shyam Shetty, and we have Monopolo. Monopolo is a volunteer and he's an auto driver from Tezpur. So he'll also be lighting the lamp. We have a very special guest, Dhanya. Dhanya will now welcome all the guests with a rose. But Dhanya is an amazing lady. She just has got over 300 broken bones on her body, but she says born to win. So here we have Dhanya on a robotic chair, a great fighter, a great philanthropist. We have a professor from an engineering college, CMRIT, Professor Dr. Sharmila, a specialist in embedded systems. And now she's going to perform an art form, very popular art form called Mohiniyattam. So what she has emphasized as a teacher to me is to focus on her Navarasas. So she's going to now show us Navarasas, the nine rasas. All of you know what it is. So please focus on her performance. And here she comes, Professor Dr. Sharmila.
ீப்ளாந்த திமிதரி கிடத்தகத்தாதிம் தகரத்தாதிம் தத்திம் தகரிம் தகதத்தி கிடத்தோம்ீப்ளாந்த திமிதரி கிடத்தகதீம் த்ராந்த திமிதரி கிடத்தகத்தாதிம் தத்தாதிம் தத்திம் தகதிம் தகதரி கிணத்தோம்பி தாம் தத்திமி தரி கிடதகதிம் தாம் தத்திமி தரி கிடதகதத்தாதிம் தகதத்தாதிம் தத்திம் தகதிம் தகதரி கிணத்தோம்பி தாம் தத்திமி தரி கிடதக கோபே நாட்டகசிச்சு கொண்டு அசுரரே துவம்சிச்ச கல்யாணி கோபே ಸಹಸಿಚ್ಚುಕೊಂಡು ಅಸುರರೇ ಧ್ವಂಸಿಚ್ಚ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ತಾಪಂ ತೀರ್ಕ ವರಾಣಿ ಕುಂದಳ ಭರೇ ಆವದ್ನಾಶಿನಿ ಶಂಕರಾಭರಣಮಾಯಿಡುಂ ಶುಭೇ ಿಂಗಲ್ ನವರಸಂಗಳ್ ಚೇರ್ತಿಡುವನಾಯ್ ತೊಳ ಆನಂದ ಭೈರವಿ ಆನಂದ ಭೈರವಿ ಕಲ್ಪಲತಿ ಕಾಂ
कैलासनाथ प्रिया वेदांत प्रतिपाद्य मान विभवां विद्वन्मनोरंजिनी श्रीचक्रांकित रत्नपीठ निलया श्रीराजराजेश्वरी श्रीराजराजेश्वरी
Now I request Dr. Kota Harinarayana, our chief mentor, to kindly come forward and make the mentor's address.
Good morning to you all. Namaste. Happy to see all of you here. The Inspired India Foundation started somewhere in 2008 in a very informal way. I think, but in 2009, the foundation got registered. The last 12 years or so, it has worked with thousands of people, thousands of heroes who have not been well recognized for the contribution they have made. And the inspiration came from Dr. Abdul Kalam, our guru. And he believed in the strength of the people, strength of the nation. And he always felt if you are strong, you will be respected. Strength, that is what. Like he always used to say, strength respects strength. I think all of us together, the young students, the elders, it should be our endeavor to see that we become a strong nation. I'm happy Dr. Somnath is here now. And VSSC and ISRO has added a lot of value to us, value to the country, a lot of strength. I'm happy that Tessie Thomas is here. And I think the Defense R&D Organization done a lot of good things. And today we are slowly realizing the benefits what are. The benefits from all these organizations are not only direct benefits, but the indirect benefit that come to us. What happens with aerospace? After 10 years, it enters into every part of our life. The technology seeps in and does that. And do believe that what Dr. Kalam felt, that the younger generation must take over. And we should continue to learn, continue to unlearn, continue to contribute. And that's what it is. Inspired India Foundation has worked during the COVID time with thousands of migrants, supported them. They created kitchens. They even transferred funds to their accounts, and they stayed with them until they are settled in their own places. All the job was done, and Krishnan and his team, without any publicity or anything like that. I think that is one of the tenets of this group, is not to seek publicity. He uses a word called no noise but only action. I think that's what it is. And I think somewhere in 2001, is it Anant Krishnan, 2001, I have introduced you to Dr. Kalam.
Yes, sir.
I introduced you to Dr. Kalam. And maybe some of you know, in spite of you being a very busy person, every fortnight he used to come to Bangalore. Papa, they will know that. And he used to review our project, and he used to meet everybody all across. Sometimes he will come at night, 11 o'clock, and he will be with us about 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and then next morning he's not there, okay? That is the way he worked. I think Anand Krishnan has been inspired by him, and thanks to that inspiration, he and his team, a lot of volunteers. Our volunteers are from all strata of society, right from people who are just working in auto drivers, as teachers, as professionals, as armored forces men, and as the senior bureaucrats, scientists, engineers, whole lot. And all of them work without asking for any recognition or anything. It is the job that they do, that is what is important to them. I think that tradition we continue, and we would like to continue to do that. So let me once again thank you all for being here. And I want to acknowledge that you all have accepted and you are here. Thank you very much for you, Dr. Swaminath. Thank you very much for agreeing to give the fifth Guru Kalam memorial lecture. Now, normally, Anant Krishnan doesn't come to the stage, but this time I request him, come to the stage, talk to them about what we have been doing, and then we'll move on. Okay?
I'll take from where Guru Kota said, you know, India is a country where a lot of people want to speak, right? So any programs, the stage is full of chairs and speeches. So if you keep on speaking, the nation wouldn't go forward. So our organization doesn't have many speakers. We don't believe in a lot of speeches, but action. As he said, really, really blessed to have gurus. So we firmly believe that in life, you need only two things. You need a mother, your parents, and you need a guru. And if you have these two combinations, I think, you don't need anything. And that is what we very firmly believed over the years. He introduced me to Dr. Kalam in 2001. Kalam's secretary, longest serving secretary is here, Prasad. He works in DRDO, a very silent man, always behind the scene, behind the curtain. So, you know, youngsters, I must tell you.
The silent hero.
Silent hero, yeah. So it's always nice to, you know, completely stay focused and action. If the country needs to go forward, don't stay under the light. Don't grab the mic, you know. We can do many things silently, and that is what we have proved in Inspired Indian Foundation, and that is why we are able to touch many people. So I'm really happy this event is really, really choreographed for the young fellows here. Tomorrow's Kalam, tomorrow's Kota, tomorrow's Swaminath, tomorrow's Major Sandeep Unnikrishnan, tomorrow's everyone. And just not, we are not talking about superheroes. As Dr. Kalam always said, you saw one of the auto drivers, a volunteer, permanent volunteer. We need good farmers, we need good chefs. We need good teachers, right? We need good auto rickshaw drivers. We need train captains, those guys, those locomotive things. So just don't focus on engineering. And of course, thank you so much for the first time I got onto the stage. Thank you for, you know, one thing again to youngsters, you know, a phrase that Amma Girish Amma, you know, she will be here. She has coined one phrase, Tiranga ki taakat. So ultimately what matters is the might of tricolor, and you young fellows, pin the tricolor to the heart all the time. You will do magic. Thank you. Jai Hind. The first award goes to a young journalist from Jammu and Kashmir. The G. Shanda Teacher Memorial Journalism Award 2021 goes to Mudassir Kulur from Kashmir. Mudassir, kindly come. And this time, for the first time, we have a specially made memento carved by a mural artist, Chandra Mauli. So that is it on stone. And we also have a cash part to it of rupees 25,000. Mudassir, aap do line bolna chahte, Kashmir se itna dur aaye.
This is a great honor for me that I am receiving this G. Shanta Teacher Memorial Journalism Award 2021. As you know that this award is in the name of a great teacher of our country whose name will be remembered forever. I am receiving this award on this occasion when we are remembering the great legend Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I like to congratulate other awardees on this occasion. Thank you.
Next is the Lifetime Achievement Award. And every year we give one Lifetime Achievement Award to military aviation, and there have been legends who have been recipients. And Dr. Kota has had to clear it finally. And this time it is Wing Commander C.D. Upadhyay. Upadhyay is a helicopter pilot. Many serve the country in different roles. And most significantly, as the chief test pilot of HAL Rotary Wing, and you know, a great human being more than anything else. His contribution to India's military programs, especially helicopters, significant. 2021 Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Wing Commander Upadhyay.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and dear students. I very humbly accept this singular honor on behalf of all my colleagues who have worked with me in the Indian Air Force, at HAL, in the Rotary Wing Academy, and in Hats Off. And I have to admit that without their support and encouragement, nothing could have been achieved. And it's a great honor that this recognition comes as a part of carrying forward the legacy and the philosophy of Dr. Kalam. It'll give us much more pleasure and satisfaction if all this can motivate all of you and the future generation. Then the purpose would have been served and the dreams of Guru Kalam fulfilled. Thank you very much, Jai Hind.
And next we have a young couple, Wing Commander Girish Kumar and Meghna Girish. And you know, this award is Inspiring Indian Awards for the social service. Meghna Girish is amma to all of us, and Wing Commander Girish served the Indian Air Force for 20 years, then 20 years in the civil sector. Recently, you would have seen his video viral. But most importantly, they are the proud parents of Major Akshay Girish, who was martyred in Kashmir a couple of years back. Major Akshay Girish does a lot of work like Inspired Indian Foundation, no publicity. During Corona, I personally know the kind of work they have done, connecting India, silently helping people. Amazing couple, amazing stories. And we remember the contributions of Major Akshay Girish as well today. 2021 Inspired Indian Foundation Social Service Award goes to Wing Commander Girish Kumar and Meghna Girish.
On behalf of Girish, myself, and Major Akshay Girish Memorial Trust, this is a very humbling responsibility. None of our work would have been possible without many volunteers, veteran and serving armed forces members, as well as well-wishers. And taking forward from Inspired India Foundation's recognition, I'm sure this will motivate us to keep doing the best we can. We dedicate this award to not just our son, but to all Braveheart Indian Army, Air Force, and Navy soldiers. They gave up their dreams so that the rest of us can dream and strive and make our country strong and proud. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Next, we have the Inspired Indian Foundation Award to a government servant. And right so, we picked up a very interesting man who was with Guru Kalam for 22 years, serving with him as the closest aide, longest serving aide. And we wanted to give this award to him a couple of years back. He refused. And finally, we used many tactics, and thanks to Tessie ma'am as well in DRDO. He works in DRDO. The very simple, humble, always remain behind the scene. R.K. Prasad, the longest serving aide of Dr. Kalam.
Thank you very much for the award. I consider this as an honor for serving Dr. Kalam for so many years. And I'm thankful to the Inspire Indian Foundation for recognizing my services. Thank you.
I request Swamna sir and Kota sir to now take rest. Now the next one is in the healthcare. So now this time we have a lot of COVID warriors whom we have identified. And now one man who is the medical director of Chinmaya Mission Hospital, yet another unsung hero, always stayed behind the scene, Dr. U. Sudhir. He has been, for the foundation, you know, we support many, many patients, and it is one of the hospitals whom we send our patients for help. Not just that, even during COVID, it has been a hospital which really did a lot of work. Dr. U. Sudhir now gets the Inspired Indian Foundation Award for healthcare. I request former NAL director and senior scientist Shyam Shetty to kindly come forward and do the honors.
At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers for this award. But I think a lot of people have worked during the COVID times. Many of them are unsung. a doctor or paramedical staff working is expected. But I think we should give a lot of credit to the other people like the police, the BBMP officials, the number of workers who contributed and came forward generously to help during these COVID times. And I think that is one of the reasons why the success rate in India is higher than many other parts of the world. And I think we should thank all of them for this success rate that we have had as far as COVID is concerned. Thank you.
Shyam Shetty sir will stay there, and now we have an award in the music category. Now this is Sri Ram Seva Mandali. A lot of Bangaloreans know. It has been promoting music in a big way, and Sri Ram Prasad, who has been the captain behind that, he receives an Inspired Indian Foundation Award for music. During Corona time, Prasad has been helping a lot of youngsters, young musicians as well.
Hello everybody, namaste. So this award makes me actually more proud of, and I thank Mr. Anand Krishnan for this award. I want to dedicate this award to my father, late Sri Narayan Swami Rao, who is the founder of Sri Ramaseva Mandali, Chamrajpet, who started this organization in the year 1939, 83 years back, when he was at the age of 14 years, young boy. Okay, now actually I want to carry on his legacy. So I started on Music Academy in his name, and now from last 4 years, we are dedicated to all the government school students, primary and secondary students, and free of cost, we are teaching music, classical music to all students. So thank you once again.
Thank you, Shyam sir. Now I request Tessie ma'am to come to the stage, and now the next one is a team award, and an amazing team members led by a very, very jovial, very energetic Dr. Radha Krishna. And remember, they are the team from C.V. Raman General Hospital in Bangalore, the first COVID-dedicated, COVID-identified hospital in Karnataka. And I must tell you, amazing team. The entire team has come forward. They have nurses, support staff. And we at Inspired Indian Foundation, in the last 1.5 years, through them has vaccinated close to 1,000 unsung heroes every time. We're very helpful. And perhaps Dr. Radha Krishnan will also agree, the most harassed group in Karnataka, right? Because the kind of stress they were in the last 1.5 years, ever smiling. We have a nursing staff as well, Hema ma'am, and support staff Rikshit. Every time when we called and said there is an auto driver, he needs to be injected within 5 minutes, VIP treatment. There's a bakery chap from Uttarakhand, he does not have anybody, please vaccinate him. So that way we vaccinate, we drove people to the hospital, got them vaccinated. This award means nothing because the kind of work you have done, but this is what the least we could do.
Thank you all for this big honor. It has been more than 20 months. As Anand said, March 2020, government said, you are going to work as a round-the-clock exclusive COVID hospital. All the beds in the hospital will be only for COVID, nothing general. So me and my team, we all knew about COVID as much as anybody else. But we said, okay, government has given us the responsibility. Let's go ahead, take it. And 20 months down the road, today we are happy that in this period, we have been able to save more than 8,000 lives affected with COVID. Then we have done more than 1.5 lakhs testing. We have collected samples more than 1.5 lakhs. And in our own hospital, now the RT-PCR testing facility has been set up. Now we are inching towards 1 lakh. We have already completed 85,000 sampling testings. And apart from that, in the last 10 months after vaccination has started, as Anand rightly said, we have been vaccinating day in and day out, working every day from morning 9 to evening, 4:30, 5:30, 6:30. We have covered more than 65,000 people. So we are here, we are working. Thanks for the recognition. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Doctor. Very proud of you. And next, and we have now a very different award. This is media. This is a team, media team, Nirmati Productions, who are shooting this program. We are not giving them award because they are shooting. And they are the people who get you Star Sports Live. They are Star Sports vendors, cricket, IPL, now the World Cup, and of course, they also, we hire them for my military shoots. During COVID, close to 15 people in this crew were hit by COVID. 15 people, and they were smashed, and we also lost a couple of them. But the way they stood together, helped each other, overcome, you know, with so much of difficulty, with that, the call of duty to produce great sports stories, military stories. Ladies and gentlemen, Nirmadi Productions, a former journalist with CNN IBN, award-winning video editor, Murali and his team. Even Murali is a COVID survivor.
Good morning, everyone. We are very honored to get this award, and our production house, this is the first time we are getting an award after so many years of hard work. Thanks for Inspired Indian Foundation recognizing us. And I dedicate this award to all my staff supports, all my team members, and my father and mother. Thank you.
That's a very touching thing. He lost his father and mother in a gap of 1 week. Thank you, Tessie, ma'am. Now we have got two sports stars, youngsters. Unfortunately, one chap is traveling abroad and another guy is playing a tournament. First one, the Inspired Indian Foundation Youth Icon Award. We give these two categories every year. We have picked up an ATP player, tennis player of India from Bangalore, Rishi Reddy. And amazing guy, unsung hero, and his parents are here. I request his father, Dr. Bhatti Reddy of Manipal Hospital, ENT Head, to come forward and collect the award. And I request the legendary Olympian, my favorite superhero, Vimal Kumar. He's here, director of Prakash Padukon Badminton Academy. Vimal, please come forward. Vimal is the director at the Prakash Padukon Badminton Academy, former player, Olympian, and most importantly, a very nice human being. So here we come, representing Rishi Reddy, his father, Dr. Bhatti Reddy.
I really thank Anand to consider my son for this award. It was a great difficult for us, both of our doctors, to send our son to sports without a medical profession. Difficult decision. I had a lot of criticism for that. But still, this is Riti's dedication for the sport, his discipline that made us put him in this line. I hope he'll do better. Mr. Vimal Kumar's heights.
Thank you so much, Doctor. And finally, most of you would have heard the next, perhaps the Prakash Padukone has already taken birth. Perhaps. And his name is Lakshya Sen, Indian badminton player. He's not here. He is a ward of PPBA, tutelage under Prakash Padukone, Sir Rand and Vimal. To take this award, we have Lakshya's parents here. Please come forward. Lakshya Sen, the Youth Icon Award, badminton. Lakshya's father, Mr. Sen, is also a coach, badminton coach at PPBA.
Namaskar. Good morning to all. Thank you to II Foundation for bestowing the honor to Lakshya. It will be a huge boost, morale booster for him and all of us. Thank you, Vimal sir, and I'll say thank you to Prakash sir also and this PPBA Badminton Academy also. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vimal. May I request Balji sir to kindly come now to the stage. And we have some beneficiaries. Beneficiaries means people whom we support over the years, people whom we started supporting. The first one is Asha. Asha is a patient with serious kidney issues. We have been supporting her for the last 12 years. Her daughter, Kirti, is here, Kirtana. She is in the 10th standard and wants to become an IPS officer. Kirtana, please collect this from Balji, sir. So that is Kirtana, future IPS officer, yeah? All right, and so Arsu was, unfortunately, he lost his father, so we're supporting for his education. Please come forward. He recently lost his dad, and this is a small help from our side for his education. His daughter is also here. The next one is a widow. She's not here. I request Mr. Babu to come. And she has lost her husband, two children. We got her one admitted in a school. She met with an accident. There is a rod in her leg. Major Akshay Girish Trust is now supporting. Now, recently, her roof blew away in the rain. So we are now shifting her to another house. This is for her support. And finally, Mona Polo, the auto driver and our volunteer. So he is from Tezpur, again, a COVID warrior. And his son is studying in a school. Today, he took leave and came. So Mona Polo, auto driver, our volunteer. We have a very small gift to give to team. This is something which you will like. Just give it to me. This is to inspire the young hoteliers you have here. This is, I request Dr. Kota Harinarayana to come and hand over this to the team ROH, because for generations of hoteliers who come here, this is done by an army commando. He's a paratrooper. He's not here today with us. He's a volunteer. Thank you, sir. Dr. Kota, kindly stay there. Now, we have some volunteers. So Inspired Indian Foundation is a volunteer-driven organization. We have different levels. This time, we are upgrading one volunteer from Mysore, who is a gold medalist from the Mysore family, royal family, Shivendru Ars. He is getting elevated to level B. He served the foundation for 5 years. Now, he will serve for the next 3 years. So Shivendru Ars, a gold medalist from Mysore University, not one gold, 12 golds. And he has been with us for the last 5 years. And next is Professor Dr. Chandrapia from Manipal Hospital, a dental expert. She is getting enrolled as level C volunteer. Dr. Chandrapia, very religiously, I'm not supposed to say, but she ensures that a portion of her salary comes to the foundation every month. And Mr. Madhusudanan, he is from Ministry of Defense. He served MOD for 40 years and now he's a volunteer. We are enrolling him as a level C volunteer. I request Swamna sir also to join now. Sharmila madam, the professor Dr. Sharmila, who performed the Mohini Attam. So thank you. I request people to come near to the dais. Meenakshi. After Sharmila, ma'am. So next is Meenakshi. Meenakshi, come forward. The MSc physics student, she wants to become an astrophysicist. You know, for all the way she came from Kerala to perform here. Thank you so much. Nivedita is going to perform in a while. She is a cerebral palsy champion, CP champion. She's going to perform piano. Dhania is, all the youngsters should speak to her. So Dhania is, I wouldn't want to use the word suffers, but then she has defeated osteogenesis imperfecta, which is called brittle bones, just 300 bones on her body. And so please come, she wants me to be able to. So we are doing many things quietly, and you will come to know very soon what are we up to. Amazing lady, all the youngsters who are cribbing, wo nahi hai, ye nahi hai, talk to her. Because she says that every pain, every bone that breaks is a lesson, is a celebration. Is the ambulance team here? Manipal Hospital? We also have a standby ambulance during all our events. We thought we'll call them. They're not here. And the Kairali School, there's a school, Kairali School here. Any teacher, 2 teachers can come. We will also give you a kalam painted. That painting, the big painting. Request Dr. Kota to hand over this painting to the team, Kairali team. the CMRIT team, some students can come. We'll give you a photograph. And this is a painting done by an army commando signed by Dr. Kalam. Okay? But this is not the original one. This is a copy of it. We have made badges out of it, which you are wearing. This is for your library. And thank you for coming every year in large numbers. So that is it. We have now the piano performance. Pleasure. I also want to welcome Balji. Balji is the boss of Royal Orchid Group, and I must tell you, to all of you, to conduct this event, it was very tough because we need support, and this time support didn't come from anywhere because if everybody was looking at Corona and saying because of the virus we couldn't support. And I'm happy that for the first time after this event, we don't have to sign a check because Royal Orchid is partner for this event. And that's a big thing. And it is not that Royal Orchid wasn't. They have supported us in many ways in the past. Balji is a very silent man, a devotee of silence but action. Thank you so much, sir. And a wonderful team of Prashant, Ajay, Srikant, Sagar, and many more.
Hello, friends. I would say that I've attended a number of functions organized by Mr. Anantakrishna over the years, but this one has been the most touching and very, very memorable for me. I would say all credit goes to Mr. Anantha Krishna for being very persistent. You know, particularly in this COVID times, resources are a constraint, but I think he's one man we can learn a lot of persistence from. And thank you very much for teaching us. And it's all his selflessness. That is what I admire. And whenever he comes to meet me, I know I could not do very much, but this is a small way. We are happy to sponsor this. Also, this gives us an opportunity for doing some CSR activity, some direction. You see, normally what happens is corporates, at the end of the year, they realize they do some CSR and just hand over a check to somebody. But here I can see, actually, you know, people who really deserve are here. So I would thank you very much, Anantha Krishna, for giving us this opportunity to host this event. And we'll be happy to do more for you in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you.